What's up, YouTube? It's the Combo Kids Stunt Team out here today at the lot. We got our buddy Juan out here. Juan, right? And right now he's riding the Honda Grom. We did a video before where we taught somebody how to wheelie in one day. This guy already knows how to wheelie, you know, basic wheelies, but it's his first day on a Honda Grom. So we're going to give him some lessons, help him out, and get him doing some nice, smooth. He's already doing it. So this intro
is taking too long. He's on his 636, and it's like... It's basically stock in a lot of ways. It has the cage and stuff, but the tire's a little weird, and the idle's kind of pulling through his like stock rotor and his brake, and he's like not getting the idle part of it too well, but he literally...
He's gonna be circling it in 5 minutes. Let's go. Let's do it.
I haven't even been on my own bike because of this thing.
Let's see what you got, bro.
That was my first bike.
Yeah.
Oh, was it?
I got tired of it within the first month or so.
Yeah, that's how I felt with this. That's why he always rode it.
What do you think so far off the start?
He's been on it for 2 minutes and he's already sitting there.
He's already killing it, so. Look at that. Getting it. So basically what he's doing is he's starting at a stop, first gear, bottom of first gear, and clutching it up right to balance point and trying to work the brake from there.
There you go.
Just like that. Oh my God. Okay, video over. You're crushing it, dude.
There you go. Look in. Look in with your eyes.
Yo, he's going to be circling today. Literally in 5 minutes. Holy shit.
He's fallen in love with his Grom recently, so.
So fun. Look, circles. Circles.
Yeah.
Ooh, that was like half a circle.
Hell yeah.
There you go. You got that, dude.
ABG.
Any bike gang. Hell yeah, dude.
So fire.
You can ride it, bro. Sure.
Yeah, keep riding it, dude. Hell yeah.
How's everything feel with it?
Yo, fire.
Yeah?
So much easier, like.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. It's so much easier.
You're already, like, sitting on idle. You can tell where you're, like, you're not using any of the throttle.
Yeah,
you're just sitting there.
And you got really good brakes on there, too, so.
Oh, yeah. That's some shit stops on a dime, like.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That's the only downside to it, is the idle only goes so high that, like,
you can't really.
Sometimes it'll shut off on you when you're in between, you know? So it's kind of hard to find that balance point. It's either too much or too much brake.
Is the idle too high?
Yeah, if you got to adjust the idle, left side.
It's probably a super hard transition from a 636 with a stock rotor and caliper going to a Grom that probably has bigger brakes than your stock bike.
Yeah.
He's getting it.
Ooh. He's really getting it though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
His hands are sore. That's it. If he wants to do circles over, for anybody, if you're learning on a Grom and you're just catching idle and you're trying to go for circles, I notice that when the idle's higher and you go to spin, it feels like you're gonna like go off the other side of the bike. So I'd recommend keeping your idle a little lower and sitting on it and getting used to it, and it'll just like turn you right into it instead of like the sketchy feeling before you get comfortable.
My ass.
You want to sit right back there when you go left.
Hey, what's it say?
You're gonna want to sit right back there when you are. Because when you're like going too quick and you're trying to force it to the left, you feel like you're gonna go that way, and it's like a scary ass feeling. So
yeah, so try and keep like your butt cheek off to the left of the bike a hair, not much, just like scoot your butt a little bit. Yep, and then use your head, keep your head tucked left, you know, and don't rush it. Get the bike up to balance point, to idle, and take your time.
Just sit on.
You don't need to get it right to idle and then start turning instantly. Just get up there, get it smooth and slow, and then start to turn your head and kind of pull it.
You feel where it's at though, and then you just dip and you're like, where did it come from?
Yeah, sometimes it just goes.
The bike does a lot of the work for you.
Yeah. Sometimes you just want
to,
like, the slower that you do it, the...
Neutral.
Yeah, neutral's impossible. Sometimes the slower that you do it, the better. Just, like, set up and then go for it. You got it. He's a beast, dude.
Mm-hmm.
He's crushing it.
Our buddy.
There we go. Like brake and gas. It's hard to find that balance
in
between.
I feel like there's a lot of brake on this shit. Like,
yeah. Hell yeah. There's a lot of brake, so it's like you use too much and it's shutting you off.
Yeah,
but if you don't use enough, it's just gonna drag you straight back. Yeah. So it's really hard to find that right in between. Like you don't need to be too far back, but you need to be like right at that one balance point.
It's like small.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. The
yeah,
idle.
That's why I hated the grommet
yeah,
at first.
The idle point's hard to find, but
yeah.
Once you get it, you got it. Like, yeah, she hated this bike. She hated it. Look at her now. There you go.
That's it.
See?
Yeah.
Right there. And now keep doing that, and you'll just keep getting smoother and smoother and smoother.
Does your left foot feel uncomfortable tapping on the ground?
I don't really know.
Yeah, okay, keep doing what you're doing. And then eventually you'll be able to just kind of glide your foot.
Glide it?
Yeah.
Just keep doing what you're doing, though. That was perfect. That's all right. What do you think? What do you rate his wheelies?
If you guys were on this Grom and didn't know how strong the brakes were, you'd understand. The brakes are tough on this thing.
What
you do have the tire pressure pretty low. So
tire
it's
pressure.
Super comfortable to touch idle on and sit there. It's not going to dip you like a maniac.
There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go.
Yeah,
that was good.
Little taller.
That was good.
Really good, like, second beginner bike.
There you go.
Hell yeah.
We were gonna say how to wheelie a Grom in one day, but this is more like how to wheelie a Grom and circle it in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Killing it, dude. Yo, that was probably your best one yet.
You, right when you're like, oh, it's gonna stall, you hit the brake a little harder and caught it back down at the gas. Perfect.
Yo, and if you want to take a break at any time, you know.
I'm learning.
Yeah.
Am I getting mad?
I feel like sometimes we pressure people into keep riding.
Yeah, we're like, stay the fuck. That was smooth, dude.
I'm like right there.
You know how when you fall, when the bike falls a little bit and you're like kind of speed chasing it, mm-hmm. It's not like your 636, but if you give it too much, it's gonna like fucking throw you. So you can just like, you can hit it real
fucking
quick and it'll like bring you right back.
Yeah, because yo, my fucking balls, man.
I know. It's tricky to stay on that point, but.
Yeah, because you're like here and it's like good and then it goes too far back and you're like, okay. Especially being someone like any taller than you, like, sitting on a base.
Yeah.
I love teaching people.
If you guys enjoy these videos of us teaching people, you know, basic stuff, how to wheelie, different
love
things, let us know, comment, and we'll keep doing it. We're gonna need to teach them how to clutch bump.
Yeah.
Cold out here.
It is.
It's freezing.
If you're like, oh, can I do this? Like, is it time? Like, he was already trying this on his big bike. He already has a lot of control. Yeah! That's great! He already has a lot of control. He knows how to wheelie. He knows how and when to pull the clutch in when he comes down. Total control of the throttle and everything. Like, if you're just starting to learn how to wheelie, keep doing that, and then come to this eventually when you feel like you can keep it at the slow point.
Yes. That was good, dude.
It's hard to remember to flip it when you're scared that you're gonna go over the bike.
A little bit lower and you'll stay right there.
It's so weird because on your 636 you need to be like further back than that. It's totally different.
See?
That was it.
That was your best one.
That was it.
What did they do different that time?
He kept it right at the perfect point.
Yep, exactly.
Little taller. Ooh, now we're going right. Okay. I'd like to see it.
We're going right now.
I'm going to take a break.
All right, cool.
That's awesome.
What do you think, honestly?
No, that's awesome.
After about a half hour, you think? Not even?
Man, yeah. I don't know what the fuck happened.
But you noticed you turned the bar to the right. And it took you to the right a little bit.
That was wild.
Feel good?
I feel amazing. I feel like $1 million.
Crushing it, dude. That was sick. Honda Groms are awesome. I would not suggest these bikes to start learning wheelies on.
I always say it's a perfect second bike.
Yeah.
Because if somebody was like, if you were like, go learn on this Grom, I would not be where I am today without that TTR.
Yeah.
Or TTR.
TTR is hiding in the van today. Yeah. We were doing some dirt activities with it, so.
Yeah, we never took it out of the van.
Yep. Hell yeah, crushing it, dude. We're proud.
Shout out to
y'all,
man.
Let's do it.
So
he's about to try a handbrake on the Grom since Trush broke the rear set.
I did.
My as you can see over here.
Sorry. I was trying to do 50-50.
The rear set's totally gone.
It's cold out, all right?
So that's all right. All good. He's just going to try some handbrake stuff now.
Because, I don't know, I have very weak girl fingers. So I like it was hard for me to pull in the clutch like while with the brake. So I would pull in the clutch, then cover the brake. And then it's just the same thing. You just clutch out. And then you just hit it when you need it.
Okay.
The same thing as brake. It's touchy. Just like
it's the same thing as the foot brake. Same exact thing.
Same
just
brake.
Besides you're using your finger and not your foot. It's tricky because it's mental. But like you just got to realize there's nothing different.
Do you think, well, because there's no, remember the Razor, how it's the handbrake and I have both feet down? Is that bad? You think?
Don't do that.
No?
Nah, keep,
cause there's
keep your left foot
no
down.
Peg. That's just a weird thing.
Keep your left foot down like you've been doing, and then keep your right foot like on that peg since it's broken. But you got it, dude. Just take your time. Don't rush it, you know?
And if it falls, whatever.
Yeah.
You gotta go bury it. Funeral day for foot Peggy.
There you go.
He hit it.
Yeah, you used it? Did you use it?
You can ride around and go use this brake if you want.
Yeah, ride it. Do a couple laps on two wheels and just squeeze the brake and feel it out. Just feel how it hits compared to the foot brake and all. Right now he's just riding in circles trying to get comfortable with the handbrake. And then he's going to get back to popping wheelies.
He's never used a new brake before. Kind of just like, what does it do?
He used one, but like didn't know how.
Yeah.
You know, didn't really use it, so. You got it. Just make sure you keep the finger on the brake the whole time. You got it. Maybe. It's the confidence, you know, that's it.
Yeah.
It's the confidence, he has confidence, you know?
You can let it come up, it's fine. You can let it come up a little bit and tap it just like the foot brake.
I'm just trying to get that.
Yeah, you're trying to make sure you're on it and you got it, you know? That's good.
It is weird when you like try to grab it like a foot brake and you forget that you have to pull in the clutch and it's literally right next to it.
Probably.
If you have a halfway decent feel for it and you want to try to stand up, go for it.
I'm trying.
It's gonna want to wobble on him. It's gonna want to wobble.
Yeah.
He's gonna feel that for sure.
No!
Woohoo! That was so smooth, dude. He almost fell to the right, but he did it.
Yo, that was lit!
Oh,
that was it!
What do you think?
Awesome. Yeah, I was nervous if I was gonna hit it. Perfect timing though.
What do you think? 5 minutes max?
Oh my god.
Not even?
Quick.
Just a few minutes. Yeah, 5 minutes max, dude. You were crushing it.
You're gonna come back next week with a dented tank and a freaking handbrake.
If you guys wanted to see what bike he rides, it's a 13 plus 636. No handbrake. Foot brake, stock rotor, stock caliper, and he does sit down wheelies on it. But he is crushing it on the Grom today. And the goal is to have him killing circles on this bike ASAP. 5 minutes in, already
he
crushing a handbrake.
I broke the peg.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah! Yeah!
Hell yeah, dude.
That was lit, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Do you feel how much easier it was to come up when you slowed down?
Yeah, when you slow down as much as you can, it comes up way easier. That was perfect. How do you feel, honestly, after one day?
Yo, I feel like I progressed a lot.
Hell yeah. Grom's mad fun, right?
Hell yeah.
Killer. Handbrake killer. After 5 minutes.
Call me Dat Blocks, you heard?
Dat Blocks. What's your Instagram again?
Dap with the ZX.
Dap with the ZX. Not with the Grom. Not with the Grom. Dap with the ZX. Go follow him on Instagram.
Look at that!
Bro!
That feels good or what? That was perfect!
That was sick, dude. Handbrake killer!
Hell yeah, that was it though.
That was
you
the one.
You brought it like right to your chest.
Hell yeah,
like,
no, was that good. Was sick.
That was good.
Yeah, he hit that. And once you learn the handbrake and it takes you down every time, you can just like foot brake. You learn how to hit it softer and keep it up, but like nailing it into your brain that the brake's opposite side of your body and your hand, it's the most difficult part.
Yes.
So. I do when it's just different right away when I get up there. It's like
it's just gonna
counteract it, right?
Yeah.
Split.
Hell yeah.
I saw you hit it a couple times.
I'm just trying to burn that shit in my head. Yeah. Like, it's such a new feeling. It's crazy.
Hell yeah. So how'd you feel today? Good?
Yo, I'm at 100 right now. Like, hell yeah.
Getting it, yo.
Hell yeah.
Yo, we are super proud of you, dude. Yeah, crushing it on your bike, crushing it on the Grom. Let them know. So yeah, like I said, if you guys want some follow-up videos, just leave some comments. Me and Trish are always down to teach people. We enjoy it. And my boy over here is crushing it, so it makes it even more enjoyable.
Next video, coming for this.
He's coming for the scrape bar.
Deep, bro. You got it, though.
All right. Thanks, guys, so much for watching this video. Like, comment, subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend. We're trying to hit 100,000 subscribers by the new year. It's getting pretty close. I don't know if it's going to happen. But our boy Dap crushed it today. Learned a whole bunch of new stuff on the Grom. Mag control. If you guys want some follow-up videos with my boy Dap, leave some comments down below. We'll do a follow-up video of him on the Grom or on his 636, whatever you guys want to see. So like, comment, subscribe. Peace out.